I lived in London 36 years, and I'm coming back to India to see what has happened in India, where I spent 14 years when I arrived in India. During this program, I wanted to see especially what is the situation about Tibetan education, and the younger generation's future depends on education. So for that reason, I really want to see whether Tibetans are making good progress on preserving Tibetan culture and educating themselves to cope with the modern world. In 1949, Chinese army entered our area, Kham, Kanze, Rongbatsa, and everybody were very scared that there's something, major thing is going to happen, their religion may be destroyed, that the culture may be lost. But they continued until 1958. By that time, the political situation went bad worse. So I went to my teacher to ask his advice what I should do. He said, now is the time for you to go and don't come back until you are helpful to others. In 1959, when I came to India, I came on a horseback crossing Himalayas, not that difficult, but thousands of people followed His Holiness in India, and they had a very difficult time on the way, and they faced lots of difficult situations in India.
Nyari bunyai tercium kita, nobling kat tempat tu, tene cijawi ada, tene bete tene cijawi ada, tene mons tak sembri cijau, tene kundiu kari cijau na, serta nyorong juga kari cijau na, serta mikangga tak tela, mondar sewuji ada, pe kandi cijau na, serta cedan pe kangga tak tere je, tene tere, tak tel nasi kuci cici hakuai, omari kari cijau yang macam cikong cijau macam, tene sembri cijau je de.
Tadi cedang la lahan pih, cedang cebji cuk nyusul la tarsema pih tu. Tiangtu dengi, dengi ba tarsema ni ba dengi cuch, cungjing nara sata siapa usu, tiangi tu baju sata lahat. Cungji leh tu jauh macam ngaya kita. Oh, cungji ni jadu run digoya sama tasam. Tama tadi cuch tu thong masam, ma tadi cuch. Allah sudi, ngakatan cuci, jauh kuru pesa di tangguh tu lekat te te debu pesa, enak kerja cun sah, tenek gasu doa, tangan mandu ngakin tan jawa meja, wah teh tasulah, kemasaiam.
Thousands of people arrived in India and they settled in different parts of the world, including India, Nepal, places like Mustang.
Tapi banyak. Pewa mampu ni malah pewa je go cutun deh sihir yade, pewa mampu nyogu yade, cijen na cawe yade, ni entar pede pede sahio pede paman pinjau teh, nombal tinde si cumbu insa, tak tiri yade, tak tene ni mat tapa rich tene je go cut tak melta yade.
When I arrived in India, we are just like an animal. We don't know anything about the country, anything about the language, anything about culture. And so I realized it is so important that we must get ourselves educated to live a modern life and also to sustain our culture. So I went to the only Tibetan school, Tandurumbaches School in Kalimpong.
My name is Lhakpa Duma and I'm from this border of Tibet. This is called Mustang. Actually, I'm a sponsor child. I'm sponsored by Klaus uncle. My mom and dad are out there in Mustang. It's a village area. I have two younger brothers and three younger sisters. My dad is a farmer, and that's all.
Dandaramchi has founded this school because during that time there are a lot of Tibetan businessmen, particularly in Kalimpong and nearby Gangtok and Darjeeling. There was not a single school where they can study Tibetan language and also their culture. So he saw this as a very, very important for the future generation.
I wake up at 5:30 and then go and brush my teeth, wash my face, and at 6 I go for study. Till 7 o'clock I do my study. After 7 I go and wear my dress. I put my school dress. After that, at 7:30 I go and have breakfast. And after that, 8:20 I go to school. Till 12, after 12 we have our lunch break. 3 o'clock we get holiday. After three I go for tuition till 4. After 4:30 I go for prayer till 5, and 5 to 7 I go for study again, and then 7 to 7:30 I go for dinner, and then go to bed.
Education is so important in life. Firstly, for the immediate, to get a good job, to get a good position, so that we can survive in this 21st century. And secondly, education can make a lot of things to purify, to rectify, to being a good human beings.
I got lots of friends from different places. I've never heard of some places, and out here, when I came out here, then I heard the name of different places, different person, and like out here I got to know different culture. So that's the most attractive thing.
There is a great concern in our community that the Tibet language may be slowly lost. So already the usage of Tibet language is declining. So I'm trying to find out what we could do about this language declining, whether there's anything that we can do to stop or to at least sustain our culture and the tradition and our language.
And when we see this situation, that we find a little decline towards the Tibetan language, and the reason are many, but the most important reason is that it relies on the parents. The parents, they have to speak their language. And another important thing is that now the older generations are slowly finishing. And that's why what is needed is that, we see, those who are able to write, it is necessary to write the short stories or their experiences or what are their, you see, occupations in Tibet in their own language, so that the younger generations or the future generations, they can pick up. And they can, you see, tell the people who could read and write, and then write their stories, their, you see, experiences, and their, you see, family background, their, you see, tradition, language in Tibet. And I think, you see, the younger generation can pick up.
One important is we have to reform the writing of school texts. We find school texts matters are very, very good. Subject matter, no problem, and everything. But the contents of a reader in a class one means the word, everything should be according to that. Suppose we have got a sky have a lot of word. Then we use a very, very simple word like namkha or nam. Then gradually when they reach to class four, then we can use a kalam or lalam like this. And similarly, word usage, technical terms like mathematics, addition, subtraction, all this word should be used day to day life so that people never forget.
In Tibet, there are so many dialects. We have got Amdo dialect. In Amdo itself, you see, there are three, four, or so many. In Kham also, for example, Pinso Angiala belong to one section, Abdogala to another, myself from Dege, and also we have got a different dialect. And it is important that we see the children, they should know which part of Tibet they belong and what sort of dialect they speak. I came to India in 1964. And then you see, I was separated from my mother. When I went back to Nepal to meet my mother, and it was 1967, and she was not able to understand my language. Because you see, she was speaking purely the Dege language, and I was speaking in such a language, you see, neither Dege nor purely Utsong. So it is very important that we see that children must be made known that we see to which part of Tibet they belong and what sort of language or dialect they speak. That is very important.
Tibetans are regarded as a unique people because they possess two special qualities, Tibetan religion and Tibetan culture. And I just wonder how Tibetans are coping with preserving Tibetan culture in exile in a place like India.